Hello guys, MrEvan312, and welcome to a quick but brilliant self-built that I made. You guys will actually probably recognize the CCS class Battlecruiser that I've built before. I've been making some slight renovations to it, and changes will be also happening to the other Covenant ships in my fleet. Now that I'm basically done with the UNSC, I really need to give the Covenant some more attention. But among the renovations of the ship, mostly weapons, reducing some of the engines, the main thing I really wanted to do was give this ship its truly unique feature. Well, technically all Covenant ships have this feature, but if you've played Combat Evolved, you've likely played through the level where you have to board the Truth and Reconciliation, which was a CCS-class battlecruiser that was basically shot down and had to go down onto the ring to perform repairs, and then your team has to board it to rescue the other commanding officer of the Pillar of Autumn. Now, the only way to do that was to use the gravity lift that the ship uses to ferry troops and equipment between the ship and the planet. And I did a little tinkering with gravity generators, and I found out how to make the perfect gravity lift. Well, mostly perfect, but let me show you. Just thought I'd give you guys a quick look over the outside of the cruiser. Not much has really changed outside. There's more detail added to below the ship. Its fixed weapon has been taken away. It's been given a few more turrets, including some more variety, including the mechs, pecs, the second generation turrets for fighter defense. And I gave it the phaser lance for the ultra-powerful glassing beam, but it can only fire straight down, so it makes the ship a little less OP, but obviously gives it its ability to do glassing operations. Two energy beam turrets, which are extremely powerful. Not too overpowered, but make the primary armament of the ship. And obviously some more details throughout the bottom, but the main thing here is the bay, the entrance bay, for the gravity lift. And here we go, we'll just go inside, and here we go. That's another thing, I replaced all the kind of more human-looking doors with force field doors by Sectam. Now here, before, there used to be these two doors, like one over here, and one over there, that you would use to access the ship. Now the only way to get in is through here, just like in Combat Evolved. And now it's been dedicated from, it's been turned away from storage to a troop bay and, of course, the gravity lift. Now, the gravity lift is comprised of four separate gravity generators. These three here, which counteract the main planetary gravitational pull, and then one back here. I won't show it to you right now, but it basically, when you're ascending, it'll move you out of the main beam of the gravity lift and put you on the floor here. Oh, okay, that is a grave flaw. I never noticed that. I have to fix that. Now, something I really need to do is add a button somewhere that allows me to open the doors. That's the main downside. I need to put some things here, but in the meantime, because I haven't published this new version to the workshop yet. Sadly, I had to make the bridge a little more cluttered, since I had to reroute the conveyors, because I wanted to keep the survival ready. Alright, we're on board. Now, all the weapons and everything, and the jump drives are operated in the first toolbar. The second toolbar operates all the doors. I believe three is all the main doors, there we go. And obviously, it operates the gravity drive. Now, to operate ascending mode, which is to move troops off the planet up into the ship, you need to turn on the gravity lift, which is one, and then press two, which turns off the gravity generator aboard the ship. The main thing about this is that you actually need to be close enough. You'll have to be on a planet to properly do this, and or at least within your source of gravity. And I didn't realize I was that high up. You have to be within like 75 meters, I think, of the ground. Here we go. So now, I turned on the ascension mode, and I've turned off the ship's gravity because you're on a planet, basically, and just having the artificial gravity on board the ship messes with the operation, so you can turn it off. It doesn't really make any difference. You can get around the ship easily enough until you're up in orbit. This will open the gravity bay doors and let all the air out. And yes, I will fix that. I didn't realize it had left a hole, but we'll jump down here. Okay, so now that we're down on the drop zone and want to go up into the ship, all you really need to do is, let's see, kind of try to center yourself. Like, see, there's reduced gravity. Don't message me. Here we go. See, like, now we're in the reduced gravity zone where we're having 2% gravity going upwards. So now all you have to do is turn off your jetpack and jump. Look at that. Isn't that the cool? To me, that's just the coolest thing. This works. I discovered this completely by accident while trying to build this machine. So look at that. And now you are safely in the troop landing bay. What I discovered is if your ship, like here, if we go there, see? If your ship, if there's a, like you've noticed before, if gravity is switched around, you'll kind of get flipped upside down and pulled feet first towards the gravity. But if you're at 2% gravity, I think maybe 3%, it just lets you drift upward. It'll pull you upwards without reorientating your player. So here, let's do that again. So here we go. And then we've got to jump back off. And then we just push off. And we lift very smoothly, slowly, and safely. Not very slowly, actually. It's a decent enough clip. It does leave you vulnerable for a second while you're going up. And if you fire, you're knocked off course. But, and I really like that. You see here, once you get up into the bay, it knocks you right into the safety of the bay. Now we're up to the somewhat trickier part, descending, that is, moving troops downwards from the ship to the surface. Now, there's a kind of trick to this. You can't be as high up, like with ascending mode. You have to be somewhere, let's see, right now the ship is 72 meters off the ground. I think 75 meters is optimum, but if we move it down to about, you have to move it down to about 45. Let's try it like that. Perfect. What we have to do to activate descending mode is press 4, and the key's done everything for you. Now see there, it deactivated one of the gravity drives, so it now allows you're being pulled down to the planet, but its gravity is far reduced, so you'll have a much softer landing. And the best way to land, just take a run and jump, hit the wall, and you drift down. Now, so I see there, I landed at 13 meters per second. I did some survival tests, and I found if you're going faster than, I think, 17 meters per second, you'll take damage, and if you hit the ground at about 19 to 20 meters per second, you die instantly. That's why you have to lower the ship, because you do pick up speed a lot faster when descending. So you obviously don't want your troops dead, hurt, or already dead on arrival. Now we're back in the cockpit of the ship, and say the ship's been all loaded up, or it's brought everything off and wants to take off, all you do is press 6 and 8. 8 just turns on the ship's artificial gravity, and then 6 just turns off the gravity lift. And then you're good to go, and then, of course, you'll probably just want to shut the bay door, and then no one can get in, unless they hack their way in, or sneak their way in, like the almighty Master Chief. Now, what I really like this build because, one, the module was really simple to put in, and it was like 7x5 large grid, and I managed to fit it even onto my extremely scaled-down CCS cruiser, and I really think something like this completes the build. I don't know if anyone else has tried gravity drives, mostly because, like I said, when gravity's too strong, it just turns you, it flips you upside down towards the gravity zone. So, yeah. Like, comment below on what you would like to see in Space Engineers, and, well, I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Whee! Damn it.